we're going to do is we are going to do a Q&A segment. Again, I do apologise if we can't get through every single question today. But we've got, you can see, look for Tiny Hat with Amla. Movements telling them something. And also Ember is roasting in vinyl scratch hoodie. Please let them know your question and queue as you queue up. There are some topics that we can't really talk about, so please do not be offended if we do say no to your question.
Don't be naughty.
So, yeah, go and see them, wave, get in the queue, and yeah, form two lines. We've got mic stands, so we'll give it a moment. Whilst we're sorting out the questions, if I can start with question number one is, how are you finding UK Ponycon?
Yeah, so far, so good. Everything's, it's such a treat to be here. It was so nice meeting everybody in the autograph sessions. Yeah, other than feeling a little bit on the crazy side because of the jet lag, what time is it right now? In BC, in my town. It is, world clock. It's 8:44 in the morning, so I just got to sleep, but instead of sleep, I met all of you, so that was cool. It was like a dream.
I feel like I'm in a dream, man.
Yeah, I'm having the best time. Thank you so much for organizing this. Those of you who put this together, you've done a wonderful job, right? Let's go! Ready. Question number one over the Ember side.
You're both musicians in your real world. How do you apply that to Pony?
How do we compare?
How do you apply your... So you're both musicians. Like, one of you was a Batman member for Hey Ocean, and the other one was a musician in many performances on like West End and stuff. How do you apply that to like Pony and stuff?
Like, how do we apply it to the...
As a voice actor, like how do you apply your musicianship to being a voice actor?
Yes.
I think for me it was very useful. With My Little Pony, it was essential that we were singers. Even like just voice acting in general, it's nice to have a base in musical theater and like have a base in music because there's a musicality to voice acting. Just like knowing where to place your voice, knowing how to not like be vocally exhausted by the end of a session, all of that kind of stuff. But yeah, it's obviously a very different beast. It's its own thing, but it's nice to have both worlds when they come together. It's really special. Yeah,
ditto. It's our instrument, right? This is what we have to work with. So being able to cross that over into multiple streams of revenue is nice, but also just getting to know an instrument to a bigger spectrum, I guess, a greater degree. You get to know what you really are capable of in voice acting. Yeah.
Thank you, and I hope for the Hey Ocean Pick collab soon.
Oh, yeah.
And pass over to...
Hello. Thank you for attending. Thank you for coming all this way. A simple question. What's your favorite British TV show?
Favorite British TV show?
Like, I'd say The Original Office.
I was just gonna say! Stop!
Making your face is like unreal. So
funny. Yeah. And it's weird because the American one is, it's amazing, but it's not, you can't compare it to The British Office. No. Also, Peaky Blinders.
I love Peaky Blinders.
Silly Bridgerton, too.
Oh, yeah, Bridgerton.
Yeah, Bridgerton's
right.
Good.
Yeah.
Good question.
Yeah. What's yours?
Maybe Sherlock?
Sherlock.
Yeah. Doctor Who, maybe.
Doctor Who. So many good ones.
So, out of all the quotes you have done with the characters you played, which ones are your most favourite quotes?
Out of all of the characters? I mean, mine's Pip for sure, but I also voice Onyx, and that has been on this on G5, and that was a great contrast. Like,
what does Onyx sound like?
Onyx is like kind of down here, like a little bit like, hey, and like does like plays bongos and like does a lot of poetry.
I want to hang up
with Onyx. Yeah, Onyx is real fun.
Sweet. Yeah, I'd say in the pony realm, I mean. I want to say both Rainbow Dash and Applejack, but for sure Applejack's a little bit better for me, like as far as just getting into the groove, and she's a little easier on the vocal cords, whereas Rainbow Dash gets a little bit annoying and sometimes I get a headache. So yeah, I'm gonna say AJ. I'm gonna say AJ for being the only guest. Thank you.
Hello. My question is for both of you. I know that when you're doing the recording sessions, you probably get a lot of directions from the other staff. I gotta wonder, what's the strangest direction you've gotten when it comes to doing a voice recording? Either for MLP or for any show you've worked on?
The strangest. This is maybe just because it crossed my mind earlier today. I was telling AJ about some of the singing sessions that we do with Daniel Ingram, who is like the musical director of G4, and he would always tell me to make Rainbow Dash sound prettier. And I'm like, Daniel, Rainbow Dash doesn't sound pretty. Like, when she belched, like, you're gonna sound like this. Like, it doesn't sound good. So that was a tricky one for me. That was weird, because I'm like, get the net, man. Like, Rainbow Dash doesn't sound pretty. She sounds like she's, you know, running over a frog or something.
Yeah, for me, it's a music one as well. For the lullaby that we sing to Sparky, they turned off all the lights in the studio room and just played it on loop. So I got to sing it in the pitch black. And it was just a really magical little moment. I think they put like candles up at one point just to create like an ambiance. And that's not weird. It was just really special.
Well, like, kind of weird, a little bit.
A little weird. I was like, what kind of performance was I giving before that? I was like, you hear that sound? You.
Like, we need to tone this down. Thanks for the question.
Hey. What's your favorite episode from the characters you've voiced, like character specific episode? And also, why do you think Pip's wings look different?
Uh-huh. It's a question for both of you and then the Pip wings.
Favorite episode of all the episodes ever? How could I ever choose you? That's tricky. That's a tricky one. I really like the. I really like the episode where Rainbow Dash has to sing the song about hibernation or about clearing the skies forever. Which she has to, the tank episode. I think I really like that one. Tanks for the memories. Yeah, I really like that one. That one just comes to mind because I had a pet turtle once. His name was Zeppelin, but he ran away. No lie. So yeah, that one's a bit that near and dear to my heart.
How does a turtle run away?
Very slowly.
Somebody asked me this earlier today, so it got me thinking about it. There's a sick episode for Pip that I really like doing. That was fun. Everybody loved you. That was a big fun. They won't die. That was fun. And Portrait Day. I love that song, so that episode was really great. But I was thinking about it a little bit more, and I think it would be Bridal Woodstock, actually, from because it was the 40th anniversary of the franchise. And that was really cool to be a part of. They included so many OGs. So
it
was cool.
Was I in that one?
It went like far back over 40. Yeah. Yeah, so that was cool. Oh yeah, the wings. Okay, what I love about G5 is that there's so much body inclusivity, I think, in that specific, like Misty is the first character to have crimped hair. It cost a lot of money to create, but there's so many things like that, and I just think that they, with Pip, they made her a little special. as I understood it, they were trying to accomplish. So I think that's pretty special for Pip.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks for the question.
How did you two both get the characters like audition?
I have an agent that I pay money. So do I.
It was really cool. I think it was probably the same with AJ, where they don't really tell you what it is. It's like this sort of like mysterious, like, come in for this audition, and then you get there and they can actually, you know, show you the gist of the show. But I auditioned for Spike when I first auditioned for the G4 show, and I was like, because I had my like little boy voice like pretty dialed in at that point, and I was like, okay, I can just like try for this backstory. Dragon. but then yeah, they and I had like a pretty decent country accent, so I was like, okay, I'll try for the dragon, and then this country pony, because usually they don't let you read for everybody. You have to kind of like pick and choose who you can read for. But yeah, I got asked to read for Rainbow Dash, and they just wanted her to sound kind of like a tomboy, so I gave her that sort of scratchy voice
that we all know and love.
And yeah, it was just kind of a fluke that I got both of them. So yeah, just auditioning and having an agent is very key for that.
Yeah, I auditioned for Sunny first actually, and then they moved me down around a bit. But I thought I was auditioning for a fairy show.
Oh.
That's what I was told for a while. I'm not even sure I knew until I booked it that it was what it was. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, I have two questions, one for each one of you. Ashleigh, this one I have thought much about since the ending of FIM. How was the last recording day? The whole day recording for that show.
I mean, I didn't think it was the end. I was like, oh, this can't be the real end of the show. Like, it can't be. And I mean, it wasn't technically, because there were other like iterations of the show. Like, we did Equestria Girls for a little bit longer, and then some other things. But it was emotional for sure. And like at that point, there were all the different characters that had kind of come into the world. And yeah, I mean, to be honest, I didn't really, it didn't hit me when we did it, because I wasn't convinced that it was the end. So it's like 9 seasons, like it has to go at least 10, and then that was 9, so yeah, I wasn't, now I'm more emotional about it, because I'm like, I just miss it so much, and I miss being in the room with all those people, especially like I did all the episodes with Andrea and Tabitha in the room. So I miss them. And Tabitha would always bring cookies every time, and I miss cookies. I miss it, but I didn't have the time.
And for AJ, how is your, how do you feel about the Terry Tale being cancelled by Haskell?
Yeah, I mean, I'm closer to that feeling. Like, I agree. It feels a little surreal. The farther away I get from that information, the sadder it gets. Yeah, I'm not happy. I'm sad. I'm sad. I too had a great time, and I miss it a lot. Yeah.
Thank you for your question.
Yeah. I'm so sorry, my friend. I can't hear you at all. It's me. I'm bad hearing.
Like, you've already had such a huge impact on everyone here today, and like in the fandom as usual. And I have this bracelet for you.
believe you're real.
Thank you for saying that. That means a lot to me because it was a lot of work. Hey, Bridel!
would you like to play in G4?
Easy answer. Pip, obviously.
The crazy thing is it's actually Applejack. Like, I've said that at every con I've been to. I've said that I'm obsessed with Applejack. A, because it's a hair, but also because I've like been a fan of your work for so long. Like, and that's an honest answer. If anybody has seen me at another con, I've said that before. Yeah, it's true.
As a fellow singer, Ashleigh, I absolutely adore your voice.
Thank you.
I adore whenever you sing as Rainbow Dash and Applejack. But I wanted to ask both of you, what made you decide to become a singer and what were your biggest musical inspirations?
Musical inspirations? Like me, I just like came out of the womb and I was like, I just did that. I've been singing forever, since before I should have been able to, just riffing in the womb. That's, yeah.
AJ, the music, ribbon in the womb. I mean, I think it was, for me, I wasn't good at anything else. Like, this is the only thing I know how to do. It wasn't really a choice. It was just sort of like this, I was very encouraged by my family. Neither of them are in the arts at all, but they were just like champions of having an artist kid, and really nurtured the thing that I loved the most, which was singing, and yeah, always like making up songs and like whatever, doing weird voices, and yeah, it was sort of just like the only thing that I could picture myself doing, so I just honed in on it really hard.
Musical inspirations?
Musical inspirations. I mean, I'm all over the place. Like, as far as like actual like my favorite artist is probably Feist. If you don't know Feist, you should listen to her music because she's incredible. And as well as Bette Midler and
I was influenced by like musical theater dames. Like, I was in musical theater a lot, so like Annie and Les Mis. Like, I grew up on like musicals, so that was, and then like Jennifer Hudson. Like, I know all of it. And like Avril Lavigne. Like, I'm all over the place. I'm all over.
My favorite quote or moment?
Yeah.
Oh man. I feel like I it's been a while. You guys, it's been a while. But I remember we're like in a cafe and we're like, there's like a fist bump that goes on. Do you know the episode? What's the one?
Salad Road Review.
Yeah, that's the one. That one. I like that one. Yeah,
I can make it sound about something.
Or was that AJ that said that? I can't remember. Oh, and Dwyer, I can make some. So that was a really good episode. It's so hard to remember or recall. There was just so many, but yeah. I mean, I like the fall weather friends where they're like compete. The first like real like competitive one where they're like going head to head. Whatever competition existed in Equestria at the time.
Running with the leaves.
Yeah, that's the one. That's the one, yeah.
Just every moment.
Every moment.
It makes them so much.
Yeah. I gotta go back and do my homework.
Thank you.
Ashleigh, what was it like to argue with yourself?
Sometimes a challenge, but sometimes just like another day at work, you know?
I just want to say it is an honor to meet you both, Ashleigh and AJ. And my question is, how did it feel forgetting the roles of your characters?
I feel like there's so many generations of ponies. I grew up watching My Little Pony as like a little girl. There's like a VHS, like a video of me when I'm like three. It's like
My Little Pony, My Little Pony.
Like it's like my first song that I remember was My Little Pony. I watched it every morning or every whatever, Saturday morning, whenever it would come on. And yeah, it was like, it was a big part of my childhood. So it was very, very cool getting cast. Two of the main six in this new version, which I don't think anyone knew how well it would do. But especially like, the ponies of past generations especially were a little bit more like fluffy and like there was less like gusto to the characters, you know what I mean? So it was really cool getting to play some real pony characters with intention and like vulnerability and like a lot of heart. So that was, it was amazing. Yeah. And then I get to do stuff like this, so
yeah.
Bonus.
It was a slow rollout of realizing what was happening for me. I remember where I was. There are very few like bookings I've had in my life where I remember exactly where I was. I was just in my condo because it was COVID. Remember that? Try not to, but it was like I didn't understand. My agent called me to tell me what happened, and I, because we had signed so many NDAs and kind of didn't know exactly what it was and what we were auditioning for, I didn't know. So I was like, oh, that's cool. Okay, so then what? I was like, so how many episodes am I in? He's like, I don't know. You don't understand. You're one of the leads in the show. And I was like, oh, so how many episodes am I in? He's like, everyone, AJ, this is, and then it slowly rolled out, like, what it was going to become and what it was. Like, it was, I unpackaged how amazing, and to this day, still get surprised with how lucky I got getting this job, yeah.
Thank you so much for answering my question.
Thank you for asking.
Oh, right, that's the one.
query that Flim Flam are related to Applejack. What do you think Applejack would react if she found out that you were related to her?
Oh, that if Flim and Flam were related to her? Well, there ain't no way those are rascals are mine. They ain't no apples, that's for sure. Those sneaky fellas? Well, I'm watch out. Don't you get flimmed or flamed. We're good for anyone.
First of all, thank you very much for your time and effort today. It's been amazing. I want to ask both of you, was there an idea or thought about your characters that never got done that you would have loved to have seen done with characters?
I'm not sure I understand the question. Can you ask it again?
So obviously you guys get right into the characters' minds and you get to know them. Was there ever like a thought or idea you had about them that the writers never did that and would have loved to have seen happen?
Yeah, well, I obviously I obviously ship Apple Dash. I mean, a lot of the time in the studio, we'd be purposefully making each other laugh. Mm-hmm. So there'd be a lot of times where I'd be trying to stifle a laugh and say the line and then try not to pee my pants. But yeah, it, the hardest line, oh man. Yeah, I feel like I'm going to get back to you on this.
Distracting for their performance. However, with you doing Rainbow Dash and AJ, two very different basic characters, one with a very strong accent, might I add, it doesn't seem distracting at all. It seems very, very natural. How do you pull that off?
The southern accent is just kind of get into it. Miley Cyrus helped me a lot, I think. I'm a little less. I think AJ's a bit more overstating the cheese. And Reba McEntire, you know Reba? Reba McEntire, she's American, very much Southern. I did a Zoom reading with Billy Bob Thornton, because his kid is really into my little legit.
Dang.
Yeah, and I was like, I'm from British Columbia in Canada. Like, I am not. I'm not Southern at all. So.
That's your when you're convincing.
Right? Yeah. So I mean, it's sort of like a broad accent. I don't exactly know what region I'm from. I couldn't tell you, but I don't think it matters because it's like she's country. She's living in the country. Booking apples. You know, it's like kind of. No, just straight up country. And then, yeah, with Rainbow Dash, obviously, there's no accent, it's just straight rasp.
Yeah.
A lot of rasp.
For AJ, let me just unlock my phone because I wrote this down. Here we are. Can you see Princess Pip being the public face of the Zephyr Heights monarchy? Zip is officially queen and administering the kingdom, and they're essentially a royal double act.
She would know what to do with that much. I think she would love it for a day. I think she would love the glory of it for a day. She'd be like, yeah, and then soon she'd realize how much she has to do and get real overwhelmed, like I am right now. The idea of that, I want to see that come true though.
Sorry, I'm going to cut in here. Can I ask no one else to please join the queue? And also, please, can we limit it to one question each? Because we are... unless you're happy to run a little tiny, weeny bit over. But I'm let me know if you need any more water. I'll get some more water for you.
Did some of the people from that side want to move over here?
Because
my queue's almost finished. And it means you'll get to ask a question quickly.
Question is for Ashleigh Ball. In the episode where Rainbow Dash finally became a Wonderbolt, we all know how difficult a challenge it is to voice Rainbow Dash. How hard was it for Rainbow Dash to try voicing her friend's accents?
Oh, and she does all the imitations.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's always challenging. That was a really hard role. The one where Rainbow Dash has to imitate Applejack. That was
real hard to do country pony action when you're, you know, like.
And then that was hard. So that, I don't remember what episode that is, but do you know the episode I'm talking about? She's like, we'll go back and we'll watch it. We'll all watch it. It'll make sense. So back to your question.
That is my question.
It was tricky, but also like a great challenge, and I think really fun to do in the studio, just to like get into the nitpickiness of trying to imitate people.
Howdy.
Hi.
How y'all doing?
Good.
How are you?
Good. Now, I just want to get an idea of roots, where we started. I'd like to hear, like, what we did before being professional voice, before we started being, you know, musician, voice acting. Like, what did you do right out of school to just get by?
To just get by?
Cry.
What did you do to just get by?
I got fired from a lot of jobs. I worked in the restaurant industry for a bit. I think I got fired from 3 of my restaurant jobs. I was a barista for a bit. I got fired from that job. And then I was awful. And I got hired right out of college. I went to Performing Arts College, and then I got hired to do children's theater. And it was like a traveling children's performance piece about bullying. So it was like, had a really good message, but it was insane to do like 2 to 3 performances a day in elementary schools to children that like didn't care that you were there. I had a shoe thrown at my head one time, but a kid that was acting out. So yeah, that was like my first real job, and I was like, I gotta get out of this. Like, I can't. This isn't for me. But yeah, that's where I kind of cut my teeth, like touring and doing. I got to do a bunch of different voices actually, because I played. There was only 4 of us in the cast, and we all played like multiple characters. I got to play like a troll and a goat and like monster. I don't know, just like a bunch of different characters.
A lot, yeah.
So that was my big, first job out of school.
Yeah, I just did musical theater. Like I worked professionally in high school, so that was kind of the thing. But before things started rolling for me, I worked at a little sandwich place called Subway.
Yeah, a little cute sandwich.
I'm trying to brag, but I was a sandwich artist, so I also got fired from that. It wasn't very good. Yeah, I was like, you want extra cheese? No problem. Here. You don't have to pay for it.
I would be that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's I don't know. I also like some sports and stuff. Like I play baseball. And, you did?
Whoa.
My position. Same.
Second base.
I was shortstop and the fields because I was hyper sweating really fast. Sorry. Baseball terms.
All right, Roger. That. Thanks for the info. Also, AJ, I'd like to give you a note that it's easy for me to remember your birthday because you were born on the same day as my younger brother.
Oh, cool! How do you know that?
Internet, if it's correct.
Right, I got a weird name. Yeah. Fair enough.
I'm just going to quickly interject that the Great Britannia Bake Off won't be running until after this panel's finished because
I am here.
Yeah, all of us are here, I'm afraid. So I'm really sorry, but it's not an hour long.
No, really.
Okay, cool. Just wanted to check that. Also, AJ, now you've announced the UK Ponycon that you used to work with Subway.
Yeah.
I am expecting someone, loads of talented artists with us. There will be artwork of him.
No way.
That someone will do it.
Wild. This is kind of crazy. I also worked at a place called West 49. I don't know if anybody knows that. It's a skateboard shop. I used to strip, take apart, and build skateboards in high school. So, sandwich art, skateboards. Go.